Hi everyone, in this video we will learn about variables. Variable refers to a memory location where we can store a value. Memory here means RAM of the computer or your mobile device. To define a variable in Kotlin, we have two options, var and val. We will start with val here. So if I want to define a variable that will store my name, I will write this line. Here val is the keyword that we can use to define a variable. First name is the name given to the variable. And as I already said that we use variable to store a value. And that is why we need to define the type of the value that we need to store inside this variable. To define the type, we use colon and then the type of the variable. And then after equals to, we have given the value that we want to store inside this variable. As this variable is a string type, we are storing a string inside this variable. As I already told that anything written inside double quotes is considered as a string. To know about the basic types of Kotlin, please refer to the link that is given in the description of this video. Now if we pass this first name to the println function, it will print Bilal because it is the value of the first name variable. So let's pass first name to println and run our code. You can see we have the output. Now we will define one more variable, but this time we will use var. So we will write the same thing, just in place of val, we will write var. So I have var, then last name, type as string this time as well, and then I will put my name. Now I can write one more println here, and this time I will pass this var. If I will run it now, I will see the output as you can see here. But the point is, what is the difference between val and var? The difference is val is read-only and the value to a val can be assigned only once. So if I try to change the value of first name that is a val, I will get a compile time error. Let's try. So I will write first name equals to new name, or you can give any value, but you can see I am getting a compile time error. So red line means we have a compile time error in our code, and it will also tell you the reason. So the reason is val cannot be reassigned. But if I try to do the same thing with last name, I won't see any error. You can see the value is reassigned. So that is the difference between val and var. You can reassign var, but you cannot reassign a val. So in your code, if you require to change the value of the variable, you need to define it as var. But if you do not require to change the value of a variable, it is recommended that you should use val for those variables. So now I will delete both these lines. And you can see here we have var highlighted as yellow. And as I already told you that our IntelliJ IDEA is a little intelligent. And it will give you hints. In this case, the IntelliJ is saying that variable is never modified and it can be declared as immutable using val. And I just said that if you do not require to change the value of a variable, it is recommended that you should use val to define those variables. So we can change it as val because we are not changing the value. The variables we defined are inside main function, and it means the scope of these variables are inside this function only. Outside this function, we cannot access these variables. Once the function main is started, these variables are defined inside memory, and once the function is ended, these variables are destroyed. So if you want to define a variable as global that you can access anywhere, you can define it outside the main function. So I can even put all these lines, the variable declaration lines, outside the main function like this. And now I can access these variables anywhere I want. And even now I can run the code and I will get the same output. You can see the output is same. One more thing that I would like to tell you is how to concatenate the output. So what if we want to call the println function only once and we also want to display the full name? So to do this, we can do a concatenation of first name and last name. And it is very simple. You just need to put a plus operator and you can pass first name and last name. Now, if you run the code now, you will get the output in a single line. If you want to put a space, you can concatenate a space as well. So we have the space. You can also concatenate a hard-coded string. For example, I can write here hello and then first name and then last name. But this way of concatenation is not recommended with Kotlin. As you can see here, it is giving us a warning. So it is telling us that we can convert this concatenation to template. And if I click on this bulb icon, that is basically a hint, I can directly convert the concatenation to template. And it will directly convert the concatenation. And this is the recommended way for Kotlin. You can use a dollar sign to put values of the variable inside a string. So we have a complete string inside double quotes, but as we are prefixing our variable names with dollar signs, it will display the values of the variable. Now it is a good thing with Kotlin because concatenation is sometimes very confusing. So it is an easy way of doing the concatenation that we can do with Kotlin. Now, if I run the code again, I will see the same output as you can see here. So that's it for this video, friends. I will see you in the next one. Thanks for watching.